Hi, ho everyone, my name is Mr. Fruit, and welcome back to our Pokemon Xenoverse Nuzlocke Let's Play, episode 19. Today's episode, we continue forth through the Steelix Gorge, I believe it's called, after fighting Rapidash X Storm Form, whatever it might be. We got our own Ponyta, which is sick, because apparently it evolves to level 40. I wouldn't mind throwing that in the team, all right, I'm gonna be honest. That thing is busted. So apparently, it doesn't evolve differently. It's a form it takes when it hits 50% HP. It then changes to Storm Form, Rapidash X, which, as we saw, is busted. And somebody was like, leave it to Fruit to know it's going to have Hurricane and switch it in to Heavenly. I didn't know it had a Hurricane. I genuinely was like, oh, it's a different Rapidash. It's completely different. It's not. Yeah, turns out. Had I known it was just, it changes and would have had whatever it had, yeah, I would have probably not sent out Heavenly. But that's what makes this both interesting and in some ways more difficult is, again, I'm going in blind. I got no idea. Half the time I'm up against fake mine guessing, having to guess their type. Just like that, I'm up against Rapid, having to make some judgment calls as we go. So yes, we have and probably will lose more to something like that. But I think that's part of the fun. We gotta beat your team though, and of course we've got the beater team waiting in the back for us to just get to the next city, so that they can take on the gym. We didn't want to overlevel them. Jess impressing me out the gate, all around. I'm feeling good. Remember to like the video. 5,000 likes each video means we get a chance in our power tomorrow. So like the videos. Currently, only Monday's episode has 5,000 likes. So. If you're not liking the video, what are you doing? I don't want to go. I don't want to have to do another Friday without an hour power, okay? I'll cry. You want me to cry? Because I'm going to cry. Just like I did last night watching the Game of Thrones episode. All right, in the veils. But anyway. Wait, I swear to God, if this... Okay, we made it. And you know what else we made? An immediate... encounter, from the looks of it, right? Oh, fudge. Okay, well, I was about to flip a coin, but we don't have to. It's Chickaboo. What are you? I don't even know how to go. I love the background, though, for this city. The little town aesthetic, like old beaten down western town. I'm a fan. This game's sick. Yeah, I've seen a lot of comments like, yo, I'd be down for more fan games if they're like this. Dude, me too. This game is so high quality. It's so good. It's criminal, dare I say. So sick. Ah, I was about to say, what's even more sick is just getting Jigaboo in the first. That didn't happen. Ground type, right? I think. This could be cool, though. We don't have a ground type. We have Sandygast, and I think that's it, since we lost our Hippopotas. Encounter. Also, good call. Throat Chop, despite it sounding like a fighting attack, is dark type. Keeping that in the old memory bank right here. And I'm keeping this in the ball. Let's go, Chickaboo. Let me find a name. Was it a male or female? I'm not sure. Type ground dark. Ooh, two types we currently don't have. It has to take care of itself since birth. It doesn't know how to provide food yet, so it plays on others' pity to survive. That's so sad. Run away. Enables a sure getaway. Increased attack, decreased special attack. I think that's pretty good for this. I don't know, but from the looks of it. No, it's faint attack, faint ears, thief, and mirror move. Okay. And it is a male. I have here twin sons. Let's... Nope. Name it Twin Sons. Perfect. Well, I like that encounter. Yes, I do. It's a work in progress. What brings you to West Star City, gringo? This isn't exactly the right city for tourists. Don't call me that. Oh, it's Betsy. I'ma do laundry with the well water. Do you need some dewy and take it? Thank you, Betsy. What a pal. And a dusk ball. Don't mind if I do. I wonder what else we could find in this hospitable city. A Blastoise with like a sick looking scar. Hey, yo, join me.
Blastoise.
Oh, dude, that's so sick. And does he have like upgraded cannons? This Blastoise is sick. Is this the gym? What is this? Geist Firehouse, Ghost Emergency Ignition Suppress. Ghostbusters! Oh, we can go in the house. It do be, it's like a saloon, yee-hoo. But it do kind of be abandoned from the looks of it. A little spoopy. Found a ghost, Jim. What is this? It's a crumpled sheet of paper with some lines, just seeming rhyme. Okay. I don't know what you want me to do with any of this information. I don't know. Don't haunt me, ghosts. I'm too young. My house suddenly caught fire, but gosh, took care of it and put out the fire. Look, there's my house over there. Nah, I just found it. It's Bonnie.
How the hell did you lose your moo-moo bell? How am I gonna get another one?
Great question. An HP up. Oh, there's the gym.
El Purgatorio.
High security prison and gym of the mysterious Caspar.
I'd never want to end up in that slammer over there. It creeps me out. Off limits. Bzzz. Every dangerous criminal will be segregated in this jail to purge their guilt.
Segregation? Come on. It's 2022.
It may seem we're out in the boonies here, but Westar's populated by the living and the dead. Ooh.
This place, the gym leader, everything is so creepy here.
Just like you, old man. I mean,
like, what did I do?
You live too long. That's your problem.
It's not easy looking after a whole herd of milk tank.
Westar City. Ooh, I like the spooky broken down. Oh, I don't like this anymore. This is creepy.
Hello. Welcome to the Pokemon Center. In this building, we restore your tired Pokemon to full health. Would you like to rest your Pokemon?
Yeah, this reminds me of that Pokemon episode. It's been a while, to be honest. But I think it was like Gengar or something, possessing people, right? We hope to see you again. Thank you.
Da, 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 da.
These books on the shelves are all in, but he's literally... They put more work in making each of these Pokemon centers more different than any Pokemon game before. So sick, man. This is the Pokemon Westar City. What are you selling? Ultra Balls? How many do we have? We have enough. Hyper Potions. I think I have Energy Roots, but I'll take a couple. Then I'll buy a couple Super Potions for out of combat. For some little top-ups. I think... Yeah, I'm gonna buy all the Repels. Perfect. That looks like Team Skull's icon.
They say something strange happens when you take Scarcluo among the tombs of the cemetery, but I've never been bold enough to... Who? I'm
assuming it's a fake mon. Something cool happened. What? Wouldn't know. Do we... I'm trying to think. Do we sauce the team up again and swap in Chickadoo? Kind of sound... Or Ponyta? I just don't know who. Guys, the good thing about Chickadoo, we would have a solid answer to Electric now, which otherwise we've had a hard time with. Although, I mean, this current team is a lot better. I'll say that. But for now, not knowing, apparently we got to do something. Again, don't want to overlevel. As far as Ferdinand, I can't really help if Ferdinand overlevels, because I have to keep him in the party. So that's a little unfortunate, but I'm trying not to use him, so he's only getting the back of it.
That ain't a tasty candy, it's a done dusk stone.
Oh, thanks. That means a lot.
My old lady doesn't want to hear about getting more children, but then who's going to help wins with the crops?
That's a great point. What are kids if not slave labor? Changed my mind. Nunville and Papillon always fight over an item called Dread Pendant. Apparently it allows them to evolve and amplify their terrifying powers. Don't remind me. Can't believe my luck when I found this place for such a low price until I realized why.
Do it be haunted?
That Garcia is always complaining about the house, but he never does anything when it comes to cleaning.
Is that my wife? I'm just kidding. Did I go in this house? No, I did. Okay. I'm just checking for free items, all right? Can't fault the guy. There are a lot of houses. Lots of places to go. Beep, beep, beep. Beep, beep, beep. Oh, black sludge. Thanks, man. Beep, beep, doo.
Tell me, boy, do you like music? They say it's good for digestion.
Is it? Whenever I have an upset stomach, I listen to some jazz, and it's fine. Sometimes I feel like shadows are chasing me. There must be some ghost-type Pokemon who enjoy haunting us. It's me. Your guilt and fear.
Like somebody want to do dishes?
Man, what are men in this town about not doing dishes? What's that thing on your hand? I've never seen such a glove before. You want to trade it for my very special item? Seems like a bait, but all right. Just kidding. I don't even, okay. Oh. We got the Sooth Bell. We have a couple Pokemon that want happiness. I'd like to be a professor one day. Sally, I have so many questions. You terrify me. Okay. Yeah, I'm spraying spritzing holy water on that thing. I'm just walking in there like, be gone. You devil, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Kid's like, dude, what? Stop. I don't know, man. Kind of sus. What, right, Sooth Bell. Leveny we need. It just takes so long to do it. Anyway. Casper's house. Oh, this is the gym leader. And he's not here, but he did give me Psychop. Thanks, man. Typically, I have to beat you to get one. It's like a bunch of something. The calligraphy is really clear. Unlike my handwriting. Actually, it's not that bad, but it also ain't great, you know? So I guess we can evolve someone here. What the fudge is this? Dressed up? Every day I come out here and use a hyper potion on my mouth's tombstone, but it still doesn't wake up. Take it. I don't need it anymore. That is so sad, dude. I can't get this emotional in the morning. Oh my god. What? Poor little kid's like, Mommy says if I keep using that hyper potion, be out to wake up, but he's not waking up. Like, good luck. Well, that's a lot to unpack. Holy wow. That is. This place is depressing. Okay, but is this technically like a new thing? Can I catch something in here? No, I can't. Service. Oh, look at my reflection on the... God, dude, this game's so sick. Praying the light being helps the bereaved relieve their sad souls. Sad they are. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm disturbing everyone. Yo, come on. This has gotta count. It's like, it's a whole cemetery. It's gotta be a different building, right? Right? Guys? Right? I don't actually know. I'm not going to catch it. However, if you guys decide that this should be a separate encounter, we'll get Ghastly. Or it could also, if there's a fake mon, I'll check to see if, Oh, that's the thing he was talking about! Scarakluo. What the fudge? Well, let me see for the sake of it, too. Hey, Siri. Flip a coin. It's tails. It's always tails. Okay, so it would be Ghastly. I don't know what this is, but that's cool. And it evolves. I'll never know. Just coming in here, fighting dead mons around. Now I'm fighting their demons, man. These are their inner demons. I'm trying to help these people. Except I'm running away from them all. So, but you know, I have good. I'm not reading what you guys have to say. I'm gonna be honest. You guys are depressing. Which is, I understand. Oh my god, now Cubone, here to mourn its dead mother, because it wears its dead mother's skull on its head. Oh my god, I can't do this anymore. Get me out of here, man.
Wait, what? Why does Dribbler keep staying underground? Did he use dig and forget how to come out? Dude! I can't do this. I'm gonna have me crying in the club right now, dude. What the fudge? You'll know when you grow up, sweetie. Jesus! Man, maybe I don't want Pokemon to have more adult themes. I can't handle this, man. Where are we? What am I? Should I? Off limits. Okay. What's on limits? That's such a thing. Tongue may be straight, but mouth hide many sharp teeth. That's so deep. How is this? This is still the town? What the fudge? Oh, is that Casper?
This being is different from the ones we found before. Oh, you're finally here, Will. Are you receiving strange electromagnetic waves as well? You're not the Ninjito, or who are you, Chico? Rude, are you a trainer? Nice to meet you, I'm Minta. Leader of the Ghost Emergency and Ignition Suppression Team, or Geist for short. You're looking for gym leader Casper, aren't you? Well, you're not going to find him here. Some black-clothed bastards have been blocking access to some gyms, areas, gyms included, for a few days. I have no idea who they are, nor what they want from the citizens.
Need some advanced GG, which I got using code Mr. Fruit in my Mr. Fruit checker. Link down below. Whoa. New cans coming out too. Cherry Limeade. Check them out. Please. Thanks.
What are you saying? Those pedos hailed from that damn team dimension. Chrysler may know something about it. That guy's a top tier genius. Oh, I've gotten an idea. Do you want to meet the other members of my squad? You know, Geist works alongside Sheriff Casper, so he could help you meet him. And I'll tell you right away, our group is tasked with a double-faced city patrol duty. During the day, we handle the occasional fire, but after dark, we are Ghostbusters. A job like ours is vital in a constantly haunted place like West Star City. So the sheriff holds a lot of respect for our team. Andale, come inside the firehouse for the meet and greet.
Okay, what is this? Spooky saloon. Maybe you should join Minta. Maybe you should poop your pants. Got him.
And Mystic Water,
another one. Wow. I think we already have one. Game's so cool, dude. Such cool route designs and everything, too. There's maybe a few too many because I feel compelled to go. Oh, well, if I get Arceus, I know where to go. But I don't. So, and something tells me I'm probably going to stay Arceus-less. Right? I didn't get my hopes up. Excuse me, ma'am. Never mind. You have nothing to offer me. You don't want to give me anything, and don't get your hopes up, because I'm going to give you nothing in return. It's a great trade deal, frankly.
Hola, Fruit. I've been waiting for you. Bienvenido to the Geist Firehouse. Here, we monitor the city to thwart fires or infestations efficiently. I said I'd introduce you to my co-workers, so ven conmigo. I'll show you the other rooms at the firehouse while I'm at it. Vamos! This is my office. It may not be much, but I keep all the team's achievements here. Over there is one of the members of our group. Come on, I'll introduce you.
I already like him.
This is Buster, my trusty Blastoise.
Hey, Buster, you want to join me?
Buster's no common Blastoise, though. You see the cannons on its shell. While returning from a mission, we met some punks who were harassing a poor Cubone. My Pokemon immediately put itself in front of the little guy to protect it from those pedos, but alas, those desperados managed to break its cannons. Buster, without its best weapon, couldn't pull it itself in our missions. So Chrysler, the team's brain, invented some artificial prosthetics for it. That Gordo never stopped surprising me. He wasn't content with just creating cannons to shoot high-pressured water. He added a vacuum function, the ideal function for ghost hunting. Isn't that right, amigo? Haha, as you can see, we're two peas in a pod. Well, there's not much else here. Let's keep going.
That's sick. Prosthetic Pokemon 2? Never explored that.
Follow me, Fruit.
Yes, ma'am.
We're now in the storage room. Here we keep our weapons for ghost hunting and the spare parts for our vehicles. Hey, Blondie, don't you see we have guests? Be a good host and introduce yourself. Come on.
No need to get so riled up, Minta. He's just a squirt, after all.
Tuh, this cabrón is Salem, the reckless who drives Geist vehicles, and...
No need to make it that long, Minta. You just need to say that I'm muy hermosa.
A boaster as usual, Salem.
Come on, Minta. No point in hiding the truth, right? Nothing scares me. Maybe they're fires or ghosts. I'll blow them away with my charm.
No offense, Salem, but you're hopeless. Come on, Fruit, let's leave this idiot here.
Ah.
Other members of the team should be upstairs. Let's go.
This is too much social interaction. I can't.
This is the relaxation area. This is where we enjoy some well-deserved rest after our missions. Oh, look, it's Will. Hey, is everything okay? You look like I've seen a ghost.
Hi, Mentor.
What's wrong?
Nothing. I just had a bad dream. Who's this?
Oh, you're right. Ninito, this is Fruit, a Pokemon trainer.
Wow, are you serious? Besides Minza and Salem, I've never seen other trainers around here. Nice to meet you, I'm Will.
As you can see, our Will here is very shy, but he's a sweet boy to boot.
You're making me blush, Minza, but thanks for the compliments.
It's the truth. Fruit, you must know that Gosh was founded by Will's father. We owe everything to him.
Dad passed away a few years back, though. My friends and I try every day to protect what he created, although I'm still not ready to...
Well, don't say that. You know that ain't true. You should be more confident.
Thanks, sis. I promise I'll try.
Good, Ninito. That's the spirit. Let's go back downstairs, Fruit. It's time to meet our last partner.
Everything's dead, man.
Come on, follow me. Hey, I'd be like, hey, I have a dead dad too, I think. I'm not really sure. We're like the same. This area is basically the heart of the firehouse, the laboratory. Here we achieve all the info regarding paranormal phenomena, studying the means to fight them back. But none of this would be possible without our genius. Hey, hola, Chrysler. Is it a bad time? I have someone to introduce you to. One of Chrysler's quirks is being a man of few words. Other than that, our team would be nothing without his work. Hey, Chrysler, will you even look at us? Just say hi to our guest.
He is Fruit, a Pokemon creator you met in Wild Bush Lose Vicinities. The kid is coming to the counter challenge Sheriff Kasker, but keep your making grunts and dropped to the recent event, blacked and gate to the gym. That's the reason why you let him here.
Chrysler, were you spying on me or something?
Negative, Captain. Simply, you weren't aware your transceiver was in function.
Whoops, meet Culpa. Still introducing each other face to face is better.
It's no time. The city is in great danger.
Huh. Could you be more specific, Chrysler?
Hey, Christ nerd, why did you call me? I hope for you it is something important.
What's going on? Why the meeting?
Shut up, you two. Let Chrysler speak. He must have his reasons.
Captain, you captured the strange magnetic field in the Wild Bull Saloon area, right?
Yeah, I have. On second thought, it was a really abnormal presence, way more intense than usual. But when Fruit arrived, I completely forgot about it.
See, a chance thrown under the bus, and it's all this squirt's fault.
Buster, shut up that show off.
Keep it quiet, Buster.
Come on, guys. This isn't the time for arguments.
Actually, if the captain hadn't come in contact with Groot, she would be a prisoner of the Salute's ectoplasm now.
Are you dumb, Chrysler? I hate Mentis' guts, but even I have to admit how tough she is. Nothing would have changed.
Negative, Salem. The captain's skills are in fact high, but not high enough. However, Fruit's arrival must have triggered something in the ectoplasm that made it disappear.
That's why when I met him, I couldn't pick up anything. Hombre, you must be a formidable trainer.
The anomaly isn't gone from the radar. It's probably still wandering inside the gloom. However, we possess no data regarding this Pokemon. For all we know, there could be more than one. We must act quickly, but we need a good plan.
I have a really bad feeling. I'm so scared right now.
What are we waiting for? To the saloon.
We'll come up with a plan to get rid of that entry once we get there.
Fruit, my sources indicate that you are here to challenge Team Leader Kasper. My knowledge might be enough to reprogram Team Dimension's robots so we can free the gym, but we need your help just as much as you need ours, so I'm asking you to assist us on this mission.
I'm sick of all this chit-chat. The last one that gets there smells like a garbage door.
Hombre, he's always so reckless. Salem, I swear I'm going to give you a lesson. Fruit, we're going to Wild Bow Saloon. We'll be waiting for you, in case you're willing to accept our deal.
It's the most exhibition I've had in a Pokemon game ever. I wasn't expecting to get nominated for voice acting this episode. Jesus. Not that I think I would, but. See, and everyone's like, bruh, Miss Fruit makes dumb. Some people are like, oh, why do you make voice? Why do you read all of it? It's more fun, man, all right? I'll make the episode a little bit longer because there's been so much story, all right?
There. Are you not satisfied?
So we're probably fighting ghosts, huh? It's a good thing we have a dark... Ooh. Actually, they even do no crunch. They even gonna be popping off. Should also save, because it's been a lot of A clicking.
A.
Although Wild Bull Saloon sounds like it would be a new named place, right?
It is. Well, maybe it's an encounter.
Fruit! So, you've decided to give us a hand on the mission? Okay, I agree. This ruined building is the Wild Bull Saloon. Not many years ago, it used to be one of West Star City's main attractions. Can you believe that? The owner, Chimpo, built it about a century ago, taking the role as a bartender as well. Every zone was finally organized. For instance, the one we're occupying right now was the Battle Room. Here, both West Star City citizens and outsiders used to fight between one drink and the next one. All good things come to an end, though. Someone spread a rumor about a monstrous Pokemon hidden by the owner. People, even though they've never seen this creature, believed the rumor, and so Chimpo started seeing, day after day, his clients disappearing one after the other until he was left alone. So, this saloon has been deserted ever since, became the home of ghost-type Pokemon. But guys, we'll never let an arrogant two-bit spirit take it for itself, run Mr. Chimpo's work. That's why we're here. Not everyone's here, guys can finally start its magic. That's right, Fruit. Till the end of the mission, you're going to be part of the team. Let's go through the area for clues. Vamanos!
Okay. Door's locked. Door's locked.
Oh, our encounter is Haunter. Oh, we're popping up.
Let me flip a coin. Hey, Siri, flip a coin. It's tails this time. Dude, why do I exist? If only to suffer. I'm be honest. How do... this should be fine. Oh, so fine. Yeah, reduce that PP. See if I care. Okay. One more. Pog. We're popping off. All right. Now we're going to swap into Jess. Now, see, here's the question. Is there Ghastly X and Haunter X to evolve into Gengar X? Or can this Haunter evolve into Gengar? Like, I have questions. Because I want that Gengar X, you know what I'm saying? Just saying. Gengar's still cool, though, don't get me wrong. I mean, I'll take it. The only problem, though, is I'll probably have to find an item to evolve it, which probably means fighting a lot of Ghastlies and Haunters over and over and over. But, hey, nothing new over here, you know what I'm saying? Let's go Great Ball. I'm feeling good about this. I'm already looking for a female name. I'm not even looking, because I know we got it. Look at that. So free. I have here Nemoria for a female name. What else? Your ability, obtain, right? Increase special attack, decrease defense. Bruh, that's actually sick. Don't pop off. Right, let's nickname you. Nemoria. Did I spell that right? I did. Welcome to the PC for now. We'll see. Our unfortunate news? No. Yep. Gengar X and Haunter X are a thing. So, they're just default. This is just what it is. Good lord. Where are the clues? Where are the clues at? Huh? I love the background on this zone. You saw the Tauroses mantled on the wall. So sick, dude. So much, like, love. Finely crafted. There's a hidden item. Manaphorium. A Golbat. Actually, I mean Crobat. Crobat's always good if you can get it there. And I do have a suit spell, but... a saloon key. Okay, well, I'll need that. Thanks, man. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, wait. Scarachno? Wait. Do you bring this one to the grave for it to evolve? Or is the other one already the evolved form? Or is this like the first one? The other one we saw is the second one and then evolves again. Either way, I don't know. Not a clue. But I guess if you guys okay the tower... Now it would be dupes, so I guess I would get the other... What? I don't know. I don't know how I'm going to do that. Door's locked. Okay. What do we got up here? Bleep, 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 bleep. I should probably just put on a repel, I'll be honest. Because I don't really want to fight any of these. We already got our encounter, so... Let's not waste any more time. I bought these for a reason, you know? Door is locked. Okay. Ah, we got this one, though. Survey says, a saloon key. Cut that I don't have. So I'm going to have to remember all these things to come back and cut. Spoilers, I'm not going to remember. And an Eviolite. Is there anyone we don't want to evolve that would benefit from that? I'm not sure. Another saloon key. Wow, we're popping off. The world is our oyster. Do I have one for this? Nope. Okay. Maybe I have one for this. I do. I like the old-timey kind of piano music, though. Saloon key. All right. Well, I reckon that's... What the fudge was that? Oh, Jesus. I'm a little spooked. Wasn't that a Taurus? Why is it a Bouffalant now? Did that change? Hombre, Salem, Gidley Demonios has gotten into you. Fruit, hurry up. We have a problem. Oh, my God. Madre de Dios. That cabron suddenly lost control and turned against us.
I'm so scared. Stop him, Fruit, please.
There's no need for you to waste your energy, Fruit. This is my duty. No offense, Grassliver. Fruit is definitely more qualified than you. You aren't even a real trainer, after all. Affirmative, Captain. Your plane I designed, Go, has a high success ratio just because my strength isn't comparable to Fruit's. All right, I know I can trust you. Thank you, Captain. Transfer protocol. Loading 10%. 40, 70, 90, 100%. Start.
Hey, Cade Demonius is going on here. Why is that tubbo flying?
Idiota, did you already forget everything? Poor Christ will save you by letting himself be taken by the Pokemon that possessed you.
What? Then I have the chance to redeem myself. Don't worry, Tubbo, I'll save your fat behind.
Hang!
I can't attack old Crassel, though. What to do?
Out of the way, Salem. Looks like Fruit wants to handle this. Hang!
Wait, what the fudge? Wait. Oh, he has I thought I was just literally going to start fighting Chrysler. Like, he's a sprite. Like, that's a high-level Pikachu. What? Of course it's a Pikachu, too. Let's start with some cheesy stockpile. Yes, please. I don't know what you have. I don't really want to find out. Spark. Okay, we eat those.
Pika-pee.
Pika-stupid. That was a crit, too. This is all but over, my friends.
Easy, easy, easy.
We'll get one more. Heal up, because I just hadn't healed out of battle. And then we'll sweep, I reckon. Oh, the paralyzed, really? That's immature. Fine. I don't have, like, a full restore. Plus, would I really use it right now? Probably not. Be-de-de-be-de-do. So that was our first heal. He's just going to slowly annoy me to death, isn't he? How much damage?
4! Nice one, dude.
But we're so slow, and he's just... Oh, my God. That one damage, and I'm... Oh, I thought I had a slow parry. Okay. Matang. All right, well, this is neutral. We take those. And we eat those. Wait. Oh, is it not? Why did I think? I could have sworn Steel resisted dark, but. Oh. Well, yeah, since that's not the case, yeah, I guess neutral. This dude ain't got nothing. Dude, pure dragon type. Very handy. Ironically, a lot of the dual types we have are cool, but that's one downfall of dual types. Is it can make what would otherwise be a good matchup harder. You know, so just having pure dragon, really handy. Zen headbutt. You already do? Yeah, even kind of making a good case as to why he should stay on the team. I'm gonna be honest. Hey, Crassler, Toto be in?
Rook.
What?
Heh, battle must have made him tired. Crassler, thank you for taking this risk in order to save us, but most importantly, muchas gracias, Fruit.
I agree with you, Sis. Fruit, you were amazing.
But it's still too early for celebrations. That Pokemon is still on the loose. Could put us against the others at any moment.
We're already short on Turbo. Crassler, I'll make that bastard pay. Fruit, give me that key. Let's settle this good-for-nothing spirit.
He's dead. Salem, K. Demonius, are you thinking? We can't split up at a time like this.
Hey, guys, don't leave me by myself.
Okay. Good luck, buddy. You just sit there and keep doing what you're doing. Because you're doing a great job with whatever it is you're doing. Oh, I got to... I only have one more paralyzed here. I mean, I can always buy more. Whatever.
Okay.
Upwards and onwards. No gas member inside. Spoopy. Repel's effect wore off.
Monka. The piano's playing itself. Ooh. Ooh. Oh. A full heal.
Yeah, keep spritzing. Keep spritzing them repels. Okay. Can't go that way. Oh. Okay, farewell. Oh, what the fudge?
Get the hold of one, get the cross, get everything.
Well, this is not inviting. A dark presence blocked the way. Well, then what the fudge am I supposed to do? Music is changing. I don't like this music. Can I go back to the other music?
Spoopy indeed.
There's a lot of them. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm waiting just for you, Fruit. You're on a whole different level than the other ones. Are you surprised that I can talk? Nothing special, really. Puppet master like me can easily take control of other people's bodies.
Oh, is it the evolved form of Papillon, maybe?
I don't know. I'm Hanjeed, a Pokemon that has resided in this saloon for much time now. These decaying walls disgust me, and I really need to change the scenery. Your presence, though, really piqued my interest. I've never met anyone gifted with both such love and such hatred. You're my real prey. But I have to admit that this hatred-filled body is not bad at all. I can get used to it. This guy behind the facade of the tough guy only wants to prove himself to be useful for his companions. Such a perfect pawn for my game. Now it's time to test you to see how far I can push this blindest body.
Duh. What a Chad. Charmeleon.
Die, die!
Okay, well, same plan as usual. Three stockpiles. Then we poop on him. As long as he doesn't burn us, we're vibing. Now that I've said it, it's going to happen. But why would he... why would he use a non-effective move when he has Slash? But he did. So who knows? We shall see. But you can't... Dude, it's over, dude. I've already won. You just don't realize it yet.
Ka-cha!
Now think about what you're doing. I'm actually going to try and BM you with a gust. Fudge. Wanted to save some of my crunch PP. Although I bought all those berries, so I have plenty of ethers. Let's go, Aven. Let's go, Jess. Don Rahor. Still fine. Unfortunately... Crunching. How much of a crunch do you probably not much? Am I flailing? Maybe I'm flailing. Fire blast? Well, that would hurt. Alright, flail's not bad. And poison. Okay. Well, at least I can't be burned. Flail will kill me here now. You can't burn me, stupid. And you didn't flinch me. And flail didn't do as much as I thought it would. I think we're fine, but a crit or like a fire blast crit or something, I think would kill us. So, we're gonna heal. That's our first fire blast. Okay, never mind. We would have been fine, but you know, we played it safe. Don't flinch, por favor. Easy. Overheat grew. Dracokin grew to 42, I think.
Okay, Dolor, Squirt, is that you?
Let me guess, you saved my bacon again, haven't you? This is absurd. I managed to get myself beaten by a little kid. I let my pride fog my mind and I acted carelessly. It's my fault we're in this situation now. I can't move an inch, as if all the energy I had been drained. That damn thing must still be roaming the saloon. Root, you're the only one that can do this. Save Minton Will, por favor. Let me tell you this, though. You may have defeated me, but I'm still the most handsome. Come on, Fruit, make that bastard pay.
Okay, I'm going to go heal. Yeah, Ferdinand is 42. I don't know. Do I... I know he's poisoned. I'm trying to get back to Porygon. And apparently I don't know how... What? Okay, hold on. I don't know if they can die from poison in this game. We're not gonna find out. Do I have to go back up and around? I guess so. Okay. Unfortunate. So, yeah. Can I even go through here? I can. So yeah, Ferdinand is gonna overlevel. So I don't know, maybe this part of the story I don't need him on the team. I don't know. But it's lame because then, like, I don't want to bother training up a fire guy, because he's never really gonna be used, but let's heal Pokemon and then I'll figure out how we're rearranging the team here. Alright, let's see here. So, at the very least, Ferdinand, anyone else? Dracokin did hit 42, but I don't think I'm going to use him at the gym, so I'm not worried about him overleveling. We're putting Blengrim in. We won't have a fire type, but Chubby Bernie would be Fire Fairy. It's just we don't really need a fire type. We already have a fairy type. So this gives us stuff we don't have. So let me level him real quick. Okay. Blengrim is evolving.
Dolph out.
What are you going to become?
Oh, sheesh. I don't know, but I already look pretty sweet.
Survey says? Oh my god. That's a terrifying noise. Blengrudge. That boy looks sick. That is definitely not like the color scheme I thought you would have. Oh, fat. What the? Oh, fudge! I'm still on rare candy. Screw me. Summary, what do you got? So, can't have attack stat lowered. Still unfortunate you've decreased attack, but good attack, good defense. You kind of seem just kind of like you don't excel at anything. You're just pretty good across the board for the most part, aside from special attack. But steel poison type, very interesting. And when I can take you back to the Pokemon Center, I'm sure there's probably some moves I can reteach you now that you've evolved. I don't know if it's going to help much, but we'll give him Black Sludge, which is like leftovers for poison types. And then, hope he pops off. I don't know. Kind of want to throw him out first, too, just so we can, team in battle. That's a sick design, dude. I'm telling you. There hasn't really been a fake mom where I've been like, these designs hit. The episode's already going really long. But a lot of it was exposition, so I'm sure a lot of you'd be like, bro, nothing happened, so. I guess I go down there or up. I don't know if it matters which way I go. But we do be in a maze. Oh, no. Where am I going? What am I doing? Where'd you come from? Where'd you go? Where'd you come from? This has got to be good, right? Egg special attack. Okay, well, that's an item to sell. Over here, we have... I don't know. Oh, there's papers over there. Oh, fuck. What could the papers pop? Paper? Wow. I'll try that again. What could the papers possibly be? I don't know. But we're... I have to go all the way back to the... Fudge. Ay, ay, ay. Ay, mi cabeza. Okay, hold on. Wait, then I'll just do that at the beginning. Yeah, okay. I mean, if I have to go back to the beginning, that's just what I'll do. Let's continue forth to where we're supposed to go. I assume. I mean, it's a dead end, so. What is going on here? That's a spoopy bull ride. All right, well, fight me.
Oh, well, there you are. Do you want to play hide and seek with me?
Oh, in this thing? Fudge. I didn't really want to, but... Something tells me I don't have a choice. Yes, keep repelling. This would be a nightmare without it. Okay. Is he playing hide and seek in here? What? Oh, yes, he is.
Peekaboo!
All right, see, I feel like they're going to troll me. Put him back here. No, fudge. Okay. Well, at least I know where he is. I'm coming. You and your churlish games. Ow. How now, brown cow? How now? I'm coming. Maybe not. Good lord. Okay, alright, they're just testing my patience, aren't they? Vroom.
Peekaboo.
I'm gonna go grab the papers now while I'm here. God, this would be an expensive little maze, though, because of these repels, I tell you why. Guess I don't need to be using them, but... Every day, the little one came to the saloon where it had an assured meal. Finally, I'd find a new friend. But then, one night, a gang of outlaws alongside their hound doom broke into the inn, raiding all my customers' money. Weststar had never been the city of trainers, so I didn't know who to ask for help, especially to protect at all costs that Pokemon. Among the people, a newborn infant broke down in tears, and one of the hound dooms, sick of that whining, attacked her. I didn't want to witness such a brutal scene, so I shut my eyes. Once I opened them again, I saw the dark Pokemon groaning on the floor. It was my friend. The kind-hearted Pokemon stood up for the saloon and that baby. The three outlaws ordered their hound doom a combined attack right away, but the small shadow threw them away in the blink of an eye. The thugs cut and ran, so I tried to reassure the customers, telling them what really happened. It was such a relief telling someone about that Pokemon strongly attached to the saloon. But the outcome was not like I was expecting. The clientele, just by the idea that a ghost had been there for all the time, got terrified and fled. Tried to explain the creature was inoffensive, but I couldn't talk to him out. Even my friend, saddened about the whole story, hid into his own shop. Since then, the saloon income crashed and no one came by anymore. This memory of mine now is nothing more than a nightmare that haunts my sleep. No more songs, no more dances, no more drinks. Everything is so sad and quiet here. Not even it came back. Now it's only me and my worst enemy, the loneliness. Looks like the third ripped page from a diary. Well, that's depressing. Yeah, this episode it hasn't been the most uplifting. Has it? Lots of kids mourning dead Pokemon and... Sheesh, man. Making me run this like a rat in a maze. Got me going like, bruh. Are we back to it? Are you back? Okay. Surely you're going to fight me, right?
Peekaboo! You know, I've always been a scaredy cat ever since I was a little kid. To help me overcome my fears, Dad used to bring me into hovels like this one. Just standing by his side vanquished all the uneasiness I could feel. Do you see this mechanical Tauros? Every time we came here, Dad put me aboard it to make me forget about my fear for ghost-type Pokemon. Every time I think about those days, I see why I decided to follow in Daddy's footsteps. But now Dad's gone, he
let me lie. I'm still a coward.
fruit possessed the body of this kid. It was actually pretty easy. Mostly because when he saw me, he started crying his heart out. It may not be that body, but his body, I feel like running. I can get used to this quickly. When I get rid of you, I'll be able to leave this wretched place and blend in your society without suspicion. And I'll be the judge of that.
Well, put it down. Put the gun down, Will.
Kadoon. It's flying type.
Such a cool sound.
I don't really think I need a setup on this dude, but nice one, damage. Everyone's gonna get poisoned, so that's fun. Black Sludge do be healing me. Metal Claw, I can't remember if it has a chance to increase my attack, right? So I might as well just see if I get a plus one on this guy. Or I could Home Claws, but again, I don't really think. I mean, if I was gonna do it, I would have done it at Kadoon, because he's absolutely no threat, but watch him send out just like Palkia. Another Kadoon. Okay, now I'm offended. However, he might then send out Honchan. So let's go plus two. A little more accurate. A little more damage. Wait. Oh, he's flying type, so he didn't get hit by the spikes. Duh. Fudge. I mean, it's fine. It's not a big deal. I ain't that worried about it. Just hit him with Metal Claw.
Oh no, he switched to Gust. Whatever will I do?
Stupid. Next up, Bulbasaur. I mean, okay. And he's immune, of course. Easy. Okay, yep. What definitely was the weakest. I guess that's canon. Makes sense.
You managed to defeat me, but I'll leave this place with this body. No, Hanji, this is my body. Go away.
Han, 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 are you trying to oppose me, coward? No one ever managed to get out of my control.
You can't understand. I may be a coward and a worthless Pokemon trainer, but if you thought you could bring me down with your words, you made a sore mistake. I'm not allowed anymore. Sis, Buster, Crystal, Salem, and Fruit, too. They're my family.
What? I just got here.
Thanks to them, I'll find the strength to overcome my fears. Ah, now my control is slipping. Dad taught me that harnessing the weakness of the souls of fragile people is wrong. But now, the sadness you unleashed on has become my will to fight. My guy's soul's burning bright. Nothing to grab onto anymore, Hedry. Get out of my body.
Okay.
Yeah, it's all over now. Thank you, Fruit. Thank you so much. Please save my sis and defeat that monster.
All right. Well, I guess we'll have to see how this concludes in the next episode. This was practically an unofficial hour of power. But we can get a real hour of power with more content. Possibly, if it's an hour of power, we might be able to do this in the gym next episode too. So, you like the video and comment down below to have a chance for a Pokemon named after you. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I'll talk to you in the next one. Farewell.